Thank you. give your friends gifts this holiday season, you don't want to buy them shower gel, popcorn, socks, lotion, or a coffee mug, because apparently those are the worst gifts you can buy somebody.
I love coffee mugs.
Dad, I love shower gel.
Speaking of, did you use any this morning?
No. You didn't get showered before I came in? Come on. People don't like popcorn? What about like the caramel stuff and the cheesy stuff?
People like popcorn. People don't want to be gifted it during the holidays.
I disagree. I used to love as a kid, you know those like big tins? And it would be like cheesy popcorn,
yes.
Caramel popcorn,
yeah.
Regular.
Oh, yeah, those are great.
Like, what great. Is the, what's the That's popcorn? Like a home, like a hosting gift, though. Yeah. If you're hosting a party, here's some popcorn.
Or like our neighbors on the street. We would always kind of like gift each other stuff like that. You'd make like a thing of brownies or something, or we'd always get tins of popcorn.
Well, apparently, those are the worst gifts possible, so steer clear.
Yeah, coffee mug, I can understand.
Barber Street wasn't doing it right, apparently. All right, there's Heather with the news. Coming up, we get to John Ewing of the Action Network. 97.1 The Ticket.
Just the right tech. That's 877 by Dell, or visit Dell.com/SB Cyber Monday.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack. Sure, you can post your job to some job board, but then all you can do is hope the right person comes along, which is why you should try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. ZipRecruiter doesn't depend on candidates finding you. It finds them for you. Its powerful technology identifies people with the right experience and actively invites them to apply to your job. You get qualified candidates fast. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you what you're looking for. The needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job in ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. ZipRecruiter. The smartest
Ticket, Bogey, and Rieger with you this morning. We do have Heather, so you know, there you go. You got a little bit of normalcy.
Thank goodness.
Thank goodness. Out there that are going to be missing Jamie and Stoney this morning.
I got to tell you, Bogey, I'm looking at the ticket tags because I'm, you know, I'm very self-conscious about what people are going to say.
Why?
Because that's me. And I take it home with me. And so far, it's not too bad. When Leach and I were in, it was
let me ask you this.
Yeah.
And that's the second time you brought him up. I really don't understand your infatuation with him. But
yeah. Sorry.
If I got you a Peloton for Christmas, would you be offended?
No. Thank you.
Really?
I wouldn't be part of the Peloton community.
I feel like you would think that I'm trying to send a message to you and almost like making fun of you. Like, hey, man, you might want to.
There's a couple pounds?
Yeah.
Do you have any idea how expensive Pelotons are?
Yeah, they're like $3,000 or $5,000 or something,
right,
like that.
Yeah. So if you get a $5,000 gift.
Yeah.
I would take it and I would use it.
I remember
and I would
one
do my
time.
Year-long diary.
And we're going to get to John Ewing of the Action Network here in just a second. And of course, at 6:50, we'll get to a story. I think it's bothering both of us. I think it's safe to say about the Lions and what they have to do here moving forward. I think it's absolutely absurd. But I remember the one time we were here. Now, I don't know when it was. It was probably late at night. And you were wearing shorts. It was, you know, summer.
Oh, and you're in front of space.
I looked at you and I go,
I don't want to miss anything. should keep their jobs. Which, of course, I threw my computer across the room.
Yeah, that's pretty offensive.
Yeah, and then I read it. And we can get into it, but I don't agree with anything this story says. Like, here, I'll just give you various reasons. It quotes Mike Flory of Baltimore. And he says the following. Baltimore Lions move if they fire Gwynn Patricia. 60 years of horrible culture and losing, not giving an opportunity to turn the Lions into a mini-Patriots, a
space suit, but we're not going to go there. The phone number is 248-539-9797. I've long maintained as well that I do think a different head coach would have been able to get more out of this roster. By no means, though, do I think that this 53-man roster is good enough to be winning 10 games or competing in this division. Well, in that case, both of these guys need to go.
100%, but you asked the question, and it's a great question because I have no idea what the answer is. Give me a reason. I can give you a reason why they deserve to go. He's a dude that plays in Seattle. Quandre Diggs. Like, how much do you have to hear about Diggs? He just got named Pro Football Focus's best safety 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. And Pete Carroll comes out and says, hey, Quandre Diggs, I use his video to teach my defense, just like I did Earl Thomas, who was another stud safety.
Freaking Pete Carroll.
And you got a fifth rounder for him.
Pete Carroll and his strong jaw chopping away at his gum.
I love him.
That mother effer, man.
Dude, he's always in a good mood. He's 70. He looks phenomenal.
He really does. He's 69. Got great energy. Seattle's such a fun team. Yeah, Russell Wilson's phenomenal.
You and I are negative bastards.
Yeah.
Like, he's the ultimate positive guy. He will outlive us.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah. He looks great.
He looks like he's in better shape than both of
them. I'm with you.
Yeah.
But Quandre Diggs alone is a reason these guys should be fired. He probably disagreed with the direction of the team, so
and
they sent
something.
Them shipping.
Exactly. Sent them shipping. Interesting.
Ship all right. Them out.
The phone number is 248-539-9797. Ticket text is 97136. Do you buy what Mike Florio is selling? You got to bring back Bob Quinn and Matt Patricia. Give them another year. Don't broom them out right now. Can you make the case for why the Lions should do that? We'll get straight to the phones in just a second. Jeff Lesson here with a sports update. 97 on the ticket.
WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. A radio.com sports station. Sports headlines all day, every day. This is 97.1.
Mother Waddles, Lions, Vikings, Sunday in Minnesota. 8-4 Vikings coming up a tough loss to Seattle. Lions have led in every game this year. Undrafted rookie David Blau, again, the quarterback for the Lions. Minnesota favored by 13. Lions didn't exactly do great with Matt Stafford at quarterback against Minnesota at Ford Field, where they lost by 12.
That's negative, Chef.
Central Michigan taking on Miami, Ohio on a surprise in Mac Tuttle game this weekend. Chips just 1-11 last year and picked by many to finish last again this year. That didn't happen. Former Tiger Lou Whitaker finds out Sunday if he'll get into the Baseball Hall of Fame. Modern Era Committee has 16 voters on it. Among those, former Tiger GM Dave Dombrowski. Meanwhile, the Tigers are reportedly in the mix for a couple of free agents. They are 32-year-old free agent pitcher Josh Lindblom. He was the MVP of the South Korean League last year. Hasn't pitched in the bigs since 2017, where he had a 7.84 ERA and a 2.03 whip for Pittsburgh. So there's that. The other is Japanese slugger Yoshimoto Tsutsugo, who has averaged over 30 homers the last 4 years. Pistons host the Pacers tonight at the LCA, 7 p.m., right here in the ticket. I have the ticket update desk. I'm Jeff Lesson. For more, 97.1, theticket.com.
Jamie, I like you because you are special.
And Stoney, the ultimate tool on 97.1, the ticket.
Look, I can't imagine that we're going to be doing this show together probably ever again. I mean, let's just be honest. But
I can't believe it's less than an hour.
Well, if we do, though, we need that Lesson Stark.
That's sports updates. Gives you all the reasons that the Tigers are looking at that free agent.
Oh, it's
32-year-old.
Fantastic.
Would he win the MVP in the North Korean League?
No, I don't know.
Is that what he said?
Wait, are the numbers inflated? Is that how it works over in North Korea? Is he really even hitting all those home runs? Or are they just saying?
He's a pitcher.
Oh.
Way to follow him up.
Wasn't there a hitter who had like 35 home runs a year or something like that?
I stopped paying attention after the one.
Oh, my bad.
So, yeah.
There is some hitter that they're looking
for. Here's some ticket text for you, Bugs. At 97136, then we'll get to the calls. You're asking, give us a reason why Matt Patricia and Bob Quinn should be brought back. Now, I think they're going to be brought back regardless, but, you know, we're asking for you because you all care.
Yep.
Here we go. Give us a reason why you two shouldn't be fired from this show. We're listening.
I got nothing for you.
Yeah. I mean, we're essentially going to be fired in three hours.
We have energy. We're asking good questions. We're not making Heather very uncomfortable. I don't think they're in the news like Stoney does.
Yeah.
We're doing all right. I don't know.
I doubt it.
No, that's not enough.
We'll be back at 10. Never to be heard from again. Here's another one. You guys sound like idiots. Patricia and Quinn, no. And then I do like this one. 97 won the ticket. You throw together and give Patricia a Peloton for Christmas. BG from Garden City. Well, you know that commercial everybody's talking about?
Yeah, no, I did that.
Husband gets his wife a Peloton for Christmas and people are outraged.
I wish I could afford a Peloton. All right, 248-539-9797. Ticket text is at 97136. Do you buy Bob Quinn and Matt Patricia need to come back for a third year? Sell us on it. Why, in any way, shape, or form, should these two be allowed to have another season? Let's talk to Alan in Grand Blanc here on 97.1 The Ticket. What's up, Alan?
Hey, Patricia and Bob Quinn really are the problem. I went to Ford versus Ferrari last weekend, and that to me was a revelation of the Lions' problem. Ford was having problems, and one of the guys, well, Iacocca wanted to get a race team in, so he talked to Carroll Shelby. And then one of the other upper-level executives, I think his name was Beebe, was trying to undermine and fight against what Shelby wanted to do, needed to do to build a race car.
Okay, Alan, what's your point? Let's land the plane here.
Okay, my point is this. If the Ford family executive can't manage a car business any better than that, and I know that was in the past,
yeah, they have nothing to do with that, so...
Oh, yeah, it does. Sure it does. Because